More than any element of design, color has the ability to make us aware of what we see, for nothing has meaning without color. This section looks at the role of color in creative designing. Color is a form of visual communication. It is a basic property of light. Form and color are the two basic elements in visual communication. Form affects the intellect. Color affects the emotions. When light strikes a surface, certain wavelengths are absorbed and others are reflected or bounced back by its pigment or coloring matter. This process gives the surface its color. Color is the byproduct of the spectrum of light as it is reflected or absorbed, as received by the human eye and processed by the human brain. It is also a great design element. The world is full of light. Visible light is made of 7 wavelength groups. These are the colors you see in a rainbow: red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. The Mr. Roy G. Biv you might have been introduced to in elementary school science. The reddish colors are the long wavelengths. The greenish colors are the mid-size wavelengths. The bluish color are the short wavelengths. Additive colors are colors that are associated with emitted light directly from a source before an object reflects the light. These colors are red, green, and blue. These are the colors we are probably most familiar with in association with television and computer displays. The additive color theory was first described by James Clerk Maxwell in the mid-1800s. When equal amounts of red, green, and blue light are combined, they produce white light. By adding the colors together to produce white, we call these additive colors. Red, green, and blue are the primary colors of white light. The combination of all three of these colors will result in white. This is called color by addition and is a direct way to prove that all these three colors do indeed come from white light. It is also known as the RGB color model. Additive deals with light while subtractive does not. This model is widely used to describe colors in print. Subtractive colors. Colors created by mixing paint or pigments or printing ink. It is the opposite of additive colors because you begin with white but end up with black. Adding more colors causes the color to become darker. The primary colors for subtractive mixing are red, yellow, and blue. The secondary colors consist of violet, orange, and green. Light appears colorless or white. Sunlight is white light that is composed of all the colors of the spectrum. A rainbow is proof. You cannot see the colors of sunlight except when atmospheric conditions bend the light rays and create a rainbow. You can also use a prism to demonstrate this. Fact: the sum of all the colors of light add up to white. This is additive color theory. The color wheel or color circle is the basic tool for combining colors. The first circular color diagram was designed by Sir Isaac Newton in 1666. The color wheel is designed so that virtually any colors you pick from it will look good together. Over the years, many variations of the basic design have been made, but the most common version is a wheel of 12 colors based on the RYB or artistic color model. Traditionally, there are a number of color combinations that are considered specially pleasing. These are called color harmonies or color chords, and they consist of two or more colors with a fixed relation in the color wheel. Color impact is designed to dynamically create a color wheel to match your base color. Primary colors are red, yellow, and blue. Secondary colors are created by mixing two primary colors, orange, green, and purple. Primary and primary, secondary red plus yellow give orange. Yellow and blue equal green, and blue and red give purple. Tertiary colors are created by mixing primary and secondary colors. Red-orange, yellow-orange, yellow-green, blue-green, blue-purple, red-purple. Primary and secondary give intermediate colors. primary, secondary, and tertiary colors. The original color. A hue is without any white, black, gray, or complementary color. If a color is made lighter by adding white, the result is called a tint. If black is added, the darker version is called a shade. If gray is added, the result is a different tone. For example, pink is a tint of the primary color red. The incremental addition of black or gray to a hue results in darker values of the hue known as shades. A shade of red is burgundy. Tint, tone, shades. Intensity or saturation defines the degree of purity of a hue. All pure hues are fully saturated. Pure hue red is without white, black, or gray, or its complementary color. Color saturation is used to describe the intensity of color in the image. A saturated image has overly bright colors. Color, value, hue, saturation. The relationship of value, hue, and saturation or intensity. How color reacts with each other. Basic techniques for creating color schemes. Here are shown the basic color chords based on the color wheel. Colors that are opposite each other on the color wheel are considered to be complementary colors. For example, red and green. The high contrast of complementary colors creates a vibrant look, especially when used at full saturation. This color scheme must be managed well so it is not jarring. Complementary color schemes are tricky to use in large doses, but work well when you want something to stand out. Complementary colors are really bad for text. Complementary colors sit opposite each other on the color wheel. Because they are opposites, they tend to look specially lively when used together. When you put complementary colors together, each color looks more noticeable. Here is an example of using complementary colors. Double complementary, two adjacent hues and their opposites. The split complementary color scheme is a variation of the complementary color scheme. In addition to the base color, it uses the two colors adjacent to its complement. This color scheme has the same strong visual contrast as the complementary color scheme, but has less tension. The split complementary color scheme is often a good choice for beginners because it is difficult to mess up. The combination of one hue plus the hues on each side of its complement. Split complementary color scheme. Analogous color schemes use colors that are next to each other on the color wheel. They usually match well and create serene and comfortable designs. Analogous color schemes are often found in nature and are harmonious and pleasing to the eye. Make sure you have enough contrast when choosing an analogous color scheme. Choose one color to dominate, a second to support. The third color is used along with black, white, or gray as an accent. An analogous color scheme. Colors that contain a common hue and are found next to each other on the color wheel. Analogous colors sit next to each other on the color wheel. They tend to look pleasant together because they are closely related. Orange, yellow-orange, and yellow are examples of analogous colors. They are blended nicely in Sunflowers, a painting by Vincent van Gogh. How do you know that these colors are closely related? They share a color. Each of them contains some yellow. A triadic color scheme uses colors that are evenly spaced around the color wheel. Triadic color schemes tend to be quite vibrant, even if you use pale or unsaturated versions of your hues. To use a triadic harmony successfully, the colors should be carefully balanced. Let one color dominate and use the two others for accent. The primary, secondary, tertiary triad. The rectangle or tetradic color scheme uses four colors arranged into two complementary pairs. This rich color scheme offers plenty of possibilities for variation. Tetradic color schemes works best if you let one color be dominant. You should also pay attention to the balance between warm and cool colors in your design. Square color scheme is similar to the rectangle, but with all four colors spaced evenly around the color circle. Square color schemes work best if you let one color be dominant. You should also pay attention to the balance between warm and cool colors in your design. Involving only black, gray, or white. Achromatic. Gray, white, and black are achromatic colors. Monochromatic color scheme is one that uses shades, tints, and tones of only one color. Although using such a limited palette runs the risk of creating a boring design, it also causes an immediate unifying or harmonious effect. In other words, all parts of the design have something in common, which therefore pulls it all together. A monochromatic color scheme. Neutral colors. The color circle can be divided into warm and cool colors. Warm colors are vivid and energetic and tend to advance in space. Cool colors give an impression of calm and create a soothing impression. White, black, and gray are considered to be neutral. Warm and cool colors. Warm color. Cool color. Neutral usually means without color. Neutral colors such as beige, ivory, taupe, black, gray, and white appear to be without color. And yet, in many applications, these hues often have undertones of colors. Neutral colors. Achromatic colors. Mystics have long held we emanate a colored glow or aura which is thought to affect the state of a person's health and spirituality. Today, chromotherapy is used to heal with colors. This form of treatment dates back thousands of years to the ancient color halls of Egypt, China, and India. A more prominent use of color therapy occurs in environmental design, the effect of color on health and behavior. Our responses to color are not just biological, they are also influenced by color associations from our culture. Not only have we inherited cultural associations, but we also respond to colors in individual ways. Research has revealed some variables that help explain individual differences in color responses. One thing remains the same in color, and that is our own color preferences are important to us. The actual emotional effect of a specific color in an artwork depends partly on its surroundings and partly on the ideas expressed by the work as a whole. To be surrounded by blue lighting in an installation is quite different from seeing a small area of blue in a larger color context. For many of us, the emotional effects of art may be difficult to articulate. There are two opposite ways of using color in representational art. At one extreme is the local color, the color that something appears from nearby when viewed under average lighting conditions. For example, we think of the local color of a banana as yellow. At the other end of the extreme is the expressionistic use of color, whereby artists use color to express an emotional rather than a visual truth. Why are all school buses yellow? The color was selected because black lettering on that hue was easiest to see in the semi-darkness of early mornings. Colors often have different meanings in various cultures. Even in the Western societies, the meanings of various colors have changed over the years. Black is the color of authority and power. It is popular in fashion because it makes people appear thinner, It is also stylish and timeless. Black also implies submission. Priests wear black to signify submission to God. Black outfits can also be overpowering or make the wearer seem aloof or evil. Villains, such as Dracula, often wear black. Lacking hue and brightness. Absorbing light without reflecting any of the rays composing it. The color at one extreme end of the scale of grays opposite to white produces a feeling of solidarity and formality. Black is a natural classic. The color of authority and power, yet also implies submission. Black is associated with aloof, evil, death, unknown, fear, mystery, dark, night, sad, murky, sinful, inhuman, fiendish, devilish, infernal, monstrous, horrible, nefarious, treacherous, traitorous, villainous, depressing, somber, doleful, mournful, funeral, disastrous, calamitous, harmful, deliberate, pessimistic, dismal, hostile, threatening, wicked, disgrace, morbid, grotesque, undesirable, dangerous, and false. Brides wear white to symbolize innocence and purity. White reflects light and is considered a summer color. White is popular in decorating and in fashion because it is light, neutral, and goes with everything. However, white shows dirt and is therefore more difficult to keep clean than other colors. Doctors and nurses wear white to imply sterility. A color without hue at one extreme end of the scale of grays, opposite to black. A white surface reflects light of all hues completely and diffusely. Most so-called whites are very light grays. Fresh snow, for example, reflects about 80% of the incident light, but to be strictly white, snow would have to reflect 100% of the incident light. It is the ultimate limit of a series of shades of any color. Never underestimate the power of this super neutral. It works with any other color in any context, anywhere. One color plus white equals an almost foolproof color scheme. White would be an inappropriate color for a wedding in China. It is the color of mourning. If a bride chooses a white wedding gown, her parents would probably not allow her to get married. White is associated with innocence, purity, sterility, fairness, snow, frost, milk, ghostly, ultra-conservative, blank, empty, transparent, honorable, dependable, auspicious, fortunate, and harmless. The most emotionally intense color, red, stimulates a faster heartbeat and breathing. It is also the color of love. Red clothing gets noticed and makes the wearer appear heavier. Since it is an extreme color, red clothing might not help people in negotiations or confrontations. Red cars are popular targets for thieves. In decorating, red is usually used as an accent. Decorators say that red furniture should be perfect since it will attract attention. Colors resembling the color of blood. The primary color at one extreme end of the visible spectrum, an effect of light with a wavelength between 610 and 780 nanometers, increases pulse rate and breathing and causes blood pressure to rise. Infants and children respond well to red. Red is for the amorous, outspoken, and optimistic. People who love red love life. The food color. Ever notice that restaurants use red a lot? It makes you hungry by increasing your body's metabolism. Red is associated with hot, passionate, urgent, danger, blood, devil, angry, enraged, amorous, outspoken, and optimistic. The most romantic color, pink, is more tranquilizing. Sports teams sometimes paint the locker rooms used by opposing teams bright pink so their opponents will lose energy. A color varying from light crimson to pale reddish purple makes one feel prosperous, a bit pampered. Baker-Miller pink, that is a deep shade of pink similar to Pepto-Bismol, is used in jail-holding cells to calm prisoners. Pink is also used to treat patients suffering from headache disorders. Pink is associated with femininity, sweetness, prime and left wing. The color of the sky and the ocean, blue is one of the most popular colors. Peaceful, tranquil, blue causes the body to produce calming chemicals, so it is often used in bedrooms. Blue can also be cold and depressing. Fashion consultants recommend wearing blue to job interviews because it symbolizes loyalty. People are more productive in blue rooms. Studies show weightlifters are able to handle heavier weights in blue gyms. Currently, the most popular decorating color, green, symbolizes nature. It is the easiest color on the eye and can improve vision. It is a calming, refreshing color. People waiting to appear on TV sit in green rooms to relax. Hospitals often use green because it relaxes patients. Dark green is a masculine, conservative, and implies wealth. Color intermediate in the spectrum between yellow and blue, an effect of light with a wavelength between 500 and 570 nm. Found in nature as a color of most grasses and leaves while growing, of some fruits while ripening, and of the sea. A secondary color that has been formed by the mixture of blue and yellow pigments. A good color for people in transition. Green is Mother Nature's color. Lovers of green may be fickle. The money color, bound to influence. In Celtic myths, the green man was a god of fertility. Universal symbolism, nature, freshness. Contemporary symbolism, ecologically beneficial. Green is associated with nature, health, regeneration, contentment, harmony, cheerful, lively, friendly, fresh, sickly, unripe, immature, simple, unsophisticated, gullible, and new. Color between white and black having a neutral hue. A good color for offices. It promotes productivity and stimulates creativity. Gray is associated with neutral, ambiguous, intermediate, apathetic, dull, drab, monotonous, mature, sober, somber, mousy, and smoky. Cheerful sunny yellow is an attention getter. While it is considered an optimistic color, people lose their tempers more often in yellow rooms and babies will cry more. It is the most difficult color for the eye to take in, so it can be overpowering if overused. Yellow enhances concentration, hence its use for legal pads. It also speeds metabolism. A color between yellow and red in the spectrum, an effect of light with a wavelength between 590 and 610 nm. Reddish yellow, a secondary color that has been formed by the mixture of red and yellow pigments. Not a color that everyone loves, but those who do are generally social and fun-loving. Yellow is associated with confident, creative, adventurous, fun-loving, and sociable. Color like that of egg yolk, ripe lemons, etc., the primary color between green and orange in the visible spectrum, an effect of light with a wavelength between 570 and 590 nm. The color of sunny disposition, the idealist. Intellectuals love yellow. It takes more chemicals in the eye to see the color yellow. Yellow can have some negative effects. Babies cry more often and longer in yellow rooms. In convalescent homes, it makes older people shake as it affects their minor motor movement. As you get older, you tend to dislike yellow because it can make you feel anxious or angry. Yellow enhances concentration and speeds metabolism. Yellow is associated with warm, cowardice, caution, fearful, bright. The color of royalty, purple, connotes luxury, wealth, and sophistication. It is also feminine and romantic. However, because it is rare in nature, purple can appear artificial. Any color having components of both red and blue, such as lavender, especially one deep in tone. The color of fantasy, most men dislike purple. Purple is associated with royalty, intelligence, wealth, beauty, inspiration, sophistication, high rank, exalted, imperial, princely, excessively ornate, rhetoric, profane, and shocking. Solid, reliable brown is the color of earth and it's abundant in nature. Light brown implies genuineness, while dark brown is similar to wood or leather. Brown can also be sad and wistful. Men are more apt to say brown is one of their favorite colors. Silver, elegant, loves futuristic looks, cool. White, fastidious. Vibrant red, sexy, speedy, high. Dark green, traditional, trustworthy, well-balanced. Bright yellow green, trendy, whimsical, lively. Light to mid blue, cool, calm, faithful, quiet. Dark blue, credible, confident, dependable. Top or light brown, timeless, basic, and simple tastes. Black, empowered, not easily manipulated, loves elegance, appreciates classics. Neutral gray, sober, corporate, practical, pragmatic. Yellow gold, intelligent, warm, loves comfort and will pay for it. Sunshine yellow, sunny disposition, joyful and young at heart. Deep brown, down to earth, no nonsense. Orange, fun-loving, talkative, fickle and trendy. Deep purple, creative, individualistic, original. Elegant and graceful. Fresh and vital. Moving and active. Powerful and strong. Professional and sober. Romantic and sensuous. Red is an intense color. It can summon conflicting emotions from blood and warfare to love and passion. It is often used in logo design to grip the viewer's attention and has been known to raise one's blood pressure or make people hungry. Red Bull gets a double dose of red in its logo and is a great color choice for a logo that represents an energy drink company. The company markets the drink as Red Bull vitalizes body and mind, and Red Bull gives you wings. Both of these phrases reinforce why red was an excellent color choice for the logo. By accenting the red with yellow, a loosely analogous color palette is created for the brand. Pink is a feminine color that conjures feelings of innocence and delicateness. It is a softer version of red that can stir up visions of little girls, bubblegum and cotton candy. The color pink is also widely associated with breast cancer awareness. It is often used in logos to add a feminine flair. The color pink is very prominent in Mattel's Barbie logo and supporting branding material. It is a fitting color for a toy that is marketed to little girls. The typeface complements the color choice and helps to reinforce the brand's positioning by giving the impression of a young girl's handwriting. Orange is made up of red and yellow and can represent attributes from each of those colors. Orange is less intense than red but still packs a lot of punch. It is more playful and youthful than red. You can commonly find it used in logos to create a playfulness or stimulate emotions and even appetites. Orange is a perfect color choice for Nickelodeon, whose target audience is children. Orange is fun, light-hearted, and youthful, which reflects the TV channel's programming. The design of the Nickelodeon logo supports the youthful theme with a paint-splattered backdrop and playful typography. Black is technically the absence of all color. It is a powerful and conjures authority, boldness, elegance, and tradition. Black can be found in many logos for its boldness, simplicity, and sophistication. The James Bond 007 logo is solid black. The color choice for the classic spy movies logo works well. The color represents the authority, mystery, and sophistication that is part of the 007 movies. Blue is calming and can stir up images of authority, success, and security. Most people can say they like at least one shade of blue. It is probably the most popular color in logo design and can be seen extensively in government, medical, and Fortune 500 company logos. The blue in the IBM or Big Blue logo represents a company that is non-threatening yet stable and established. When Rand redesigned the IBM logo, he replaced the solid type with 8 horizontal bars to represent speed and dynamism. While the logo typically is not used in its original blue today, it is still a very prominent color in the IBM brand. Green represents life and renewal. It is a restful and soothing color, but can also represent jealousy and inexperience. You can often find it used in companies that want to portray themselves as eco-friendly. Green is a suitable logo color choice for a TV channel whose programming focuses solely on nature and animals. We perceive various tones of green are right on for this channel. The color conjures up imagery of jungles, grasses, and nature in general. Yellow, much like red, can have conflicting messages. It can represent sunshine and happiness or caution and cowardice. Yellow is bright and highly visible, which is why it can often be found on caution and other road signs. Yellow is also used in logo design to get attention, create happiness and warmth. We all know the successful McDonald's franchise and their slogan, "I am loving it." Like Red Bull, McDonald's uses a loosely analogous color palette. The difference is that McDonald's is mainly yellow, which fitting for this brand that focuses on children, playfulness, and happiness. The red works well as an accent color and has been known to raise one's blood pressure and evoke hunger. Incidentally, this color combination has influenced many other fast food chains. Colors convey feelings, moods, and affect the way we perceive things. For example, while driving, you see the following sign. 4 things to keep in mind when choosing color for your projects. Decide the mood you want from your work and the reactions or thoughts you are hoping to create when your finished artwork is viewed. Select the color that best evokes this purpose. Explore the possibilities by considering the various color swatches until you arrive at the most desirable. Match the chosen color swatches to the materials you are using. A dark tertiary color with a yellowish or reddish hue. Solid, reliable brown is the color of earth and is abundant in nature. Light brown implies genuineness, while dark brown is similar to wood or leather. Brown can also be sad and wistful. Men are more apt to say that brown is one of their favorite colors. Dark tertiary colors are associated with earth, nature, dirt, tanned, drab, coffee, solid, and sad. Earthy and natural. Matte, glossy. Glitter, fluorescent. Smooth, reflective. Rich color. Dull color. Rich not only describes a taste, but is also suggestive of taste level. Think olives in a martini glass, robust wines, elegant aubergine purples, succulent berries, espresso browns, often accentuated with glints of gold. These are complex, sophisticated mixes appealing to an upscale audience. Beginning in early childhood, there is an expectation that certain colors will be sweet. The eye literally entices the taste buds with luscious peaches, apricots, berries, cherries, grapes, creams, custard yellows, candy pinks, mochas, and the ultimate enticement of chocolate brown. Titillating, flavorful, and a little bit flirty, these come-hither colors cajole the viewer into what psychologists refer to as a high arousal mode. Advancing forward in the line of vision, they prove to stimulate appetites of all kinds in energetic, red-based shades of cherry, tangerine, cranberry, raspberry, sparkling grape, and snow cone purple. This is the palette that commands, "You will not ignore me." The visibility and energy factor is high, as is the demand for attention reflected in the volatile red, orange, and red-purple families, as well as in the signal yellows and yellow-greens. Interjecting black into the mix further empowers these combinations while at the same time adding a dramatic contrast. Sentimental colors evoke thoughts of yesteryear. Delicately pressed flowers, tinted postcards, faded photos in an old album, vintage ads and posters. These are the shades dusted over with time, nostalgic and reminiscent of another era. Sepia browns, grays and tops, the blues that are the colors of dried hydrangeas, ash roses and wistful mauves. Woodland hues extend far beyond inevitable greens and browns to inspiration derived from the intricate colors of leaves and foliage commingled on the autumnal forest floor. This is a dramatically intense mosaic of golden russet, fir, green, magenta, citron, fiery red, deep vine, and chestnut brown. Mid to dark in value, the mysterious hues symbolize the unknown, the intrigue that never fails to fascinate the human eye. The mixtures are unusual and not at all formulaic, yet the message is beguiling, and in its collection of enchanting purples and wines, otherworldly greens, deep aubergines, and hazy grays. This section reviewed the role of color in creative designing.